Hi everyone, welcome to Be Smart Together. Before we start, please click subscribe and turn on the notification to avoid missing valuable videos. Also, feel free to drop a comment below. I created this video to respond to one of the comments regarding grouped running year to date. Let us begin. Say, you have sales data containing order date, delivery date, customer ID, store ID, sales year, sales value and etc. We turn the data into a dynamic report like this one. Or we dynamically change the report to this one. Maybe this one? Perhaps this one? All you need is to change the input field, or update the field selection and refresh the report. Let me walk you through it step by step. Firstly, let's get the data to Power Query Editor. Expand the query pane, and then duplicate the sales data query. Rename the query to Summary. Select all columns, and then apply Detect Data Type function. Go to the Delivery Date column, Alt down arrow key to get the column list. Simply filter for any date. The next step is to select the calendar year and financial year columns, merge them, and name the merged column timeline. Now go to the formula bar. We want to add a separator between the double quote. This separator splits text into the following text line. You would usually add the separator during the merge. Take a look at the timeline column. The text is split into two rows. The next thing to do is to group rows to get the summary view. Switch to Advance, and then select Sales Channel for the one and Timeline for the second one. If you're a keyboard person like me, hit the letter T, and it will take you to the timeline. Name the new column Sales, select Sum for the operation. And we want to sum the Sales column. Select the Timeline column. We want to pivot this column to get this view. The Sales column is the Value column. We have completed the frame. We will come back to modify the code later. Let us now get other relevant input done. We want to create a reference query from the Sales data query. Then rename it to Column Names. We want a list of column names. Can you please let me know which function we need? That's right. Table.ColumnNames. Add a custom function, then type a formula in the formula bar. Now load the column names list to Excel, and we want to use it for our drop-down list. Rename the worksheet to Parameter. Let's set up helper and input fields. We want to count if the column names contain 8, and we need an asterisk symbol to help us. It is a wildcard symbol in Excel. Now, we want to use the filter formula to help us to get a list that contains the keyword, date. The last field, selection, is an input field to Power Query. So, we want to turn it into a table. Change the table style to none, untick the filter button, and then update the table name to selection. We want to create a drop-down list with column names as the selection list. Let's quickly create a drop-down list. We want to select list from the drop-down value, and refer the range to the column names list. Our first selection is sales channel. Copy directly from above cell. Select calendar year and financial year for the following two selections input. We have done this part. Now load the summary query to Excel. Then, rename the worksheet to summary. Insert rows and columns for the criteria table and slicer. Now add the criteria table. Current month will drive the date field to criteria in Power Query, and filter date allows us to switch between dates columns. We want to add a drop-down list to the filter date field. We want to use the offset formula to create a dynamic range because the lookup is written in the filter formula, which means we can't use an Excel table to create a dynamic name range. Select the delivery date from the drop-down list, then turn the criteria table into an Excel table. Untick header row to remove column header and rename the table to input criteria. It is time to import the tables into Power Query. There are three transformation steps we need to turn the table into my preferred data format. Step 1, transpose table. Step 2, promote the first row as headers. The last step is detect data type. You will see the date is being detected as date time. Change it to date. Let's duplicate this query. Then rename it to selection. Delete out all the steps except source. Update the name in the formula bar to selection. Then convert the selected column to list. It is time to modify the M code in the summary query. Let us start the modification from the filtered row step. Go to the formula bar and update the highlighted code. Go back to the formula bar again and update the other highlighted code. Go to the merged column step and move it after the group row step. I transformed it in the wrong order. Let's continue modifying the code. We want to update the highlighted code, which is a static code. Again, the highlighted code is a static code and we want to update the code. The highlighted code transforms the calendar year column into a text type column. It will return an error if calendar year is not part of the selection. Therefore, we are applying try otherwise to prevent error. To prevent error, we want to apply try otherwise for the pivoted column step. Then, if there is an error, go to the group row step. Let's go back to Excel and finalize the rest. Highlight the column header, then use F2 and Enter to fix the format quickly. Update the table format. You can choose whatever color you like. The last thing to add is the slicer. Select sales channel. It is time to test the outcome. Let's start with dropping the financial year and then refresh the summary table. Now changing the calendar year to the financial year. Let's add store ID this time, then update the summary table. Instead of changing the selection field, let's change the date to May 2019 and the field date to order date in time. Let us change it to the initial setting and refresh the summary table. All tests are now completed. Hooray! We just completed a dynamic report. Thank you for watching, and I hope you find this video helpful. Please don't forget to click like if you like the video.